If you're trying to access your Gmail or Google Apps account, same thing, via an IMAP email application such as Outlook, these are the settings that you use to do that. So this works, we've tested it. There is one hiccup that has relatively recently been implemented by Google to kind of trip you up and stop you making this work. What you need to do is you need to go to a particular page, and it's this page here. You can navigate to it or just use this link, which I'll provide. And what you've got to do is you've got to scroll down here and you've got to find this, allow less secure apps and turn it to on. And this is your slider. You can turn it off and you can turn it on. By default nowadays, it's off. And what that basically means is when it's off, then using a third-party application like Outlook to access your Gmail account won't work. And you have to turn this on in order for it to work. One thing to understand about accessing your email accounts via IMAP is that most email service providers, such as Google, don't want you to do this. They have to conform to the standard, IMAP, and allow it to happen, but it's not really of interest because what they want is they want you to log in to your Gmail account and access your email within the browser, because that way they can advertise to you, they can track what you're doing. When you access your email via IMAP, all that happens is your emails get transferred, but you're not being controlled by them, you're not being brainwashed by them because you're not in their interface that they control. They don't control what it looks like in Outlook or any other IMAP-based device. So all of these different service providers tend to make it a little bit difficult to use IMAP when you first set it up, because it's just basically not in their interest. Hence, you've got to go in and you've got to turn this setting on. Why they can't just allow it to be on to start with and to allow IMAP access? Well, the excuse they give is that all of these other devices are less secure, and they work on a little bit of fear there that you think, well, if I turn this on, I'm going to have problems. But we've never encountered any to date. So anyway, that's what you've got to do. Just flip that on, and then you should find, by putting these configuration settings into Outlook or whatever application, whether it's maybe you're using a Mac and maybe you're using the Apple email interface, it's the same settings, then it should work.